That's not yours. Hey!
I hate your mom. JK, she's a MILF. Can we have a sleepover?
His paws? Adorable. His ears? Adorable. His tail? Adorable. His face? Adorable.
And it went like...
A little bit of Monica in my life. A little bit of Erica by my side. A little bit...
Big guys, boy.
Big guys. Эта ночь будет жарко, нам будет горячо. Я беру тебя за бедра.
A slobbery.
And why do you build me up? Buy the cup, baby, just to let me down and mess me around. And then worst of all, you never call, baby, when you say you will.
What you doing? Hi, baby.
Hello. Hi. Hi. Hello. Come on.
I hate everyone, but man, oh man, you're my best friend. I'll scream it all the nothingness. There ain't nothing that I need. Well, hard and heavy pumpkin pie.
You're breaking me, la 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 la. You're breaking me, la 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 la. You're breaking me, la 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 la. I'm just right here dancing around to the rhythm.
Hey, buddy. Oh, wow. Hey, man. Hey, what the fuck?
Yelling at this. Should the cat notice me? Oh my god, the cat noticed me now. Oh my god. What is going on? Oh my god. What the fuck?
I get asked quite a lot if Todd bites, and I always say yes, it's on accident. So he did just happen to bite me. So if you don't like blood, then I don't advise you to watch. But he did bite me on my hand. It was an accident, like I said. I come outside and I bring his treats in a jar just so it's easier, and he went to go grab the jar when I wasn't looking and he grabbed my hand. So it was completely on accident, and I don't blame him for it, and I'm not mad at him for it. He's still a good boy. It's just accidents happen when you own animals like these. Okay, let's talk animal safety, because anytime I post a video with Todd wearing his tracker, I get the comment, oh my god, he's wearing a shock collar. And I would just simply never put a shock collar on him because it's not needed. But it is a tracker, and the reason he wears it is because he's escaped twice. And the first time wasn't serious, but the second time he was actually out for 8 days and went 20 miles away. So after we got him back is when I got that tracker. And some things about this tracker is the battery lasts for 2 to 3 days, and it notifies me if he were to exit the perimeter that I set up virtually. There's no actual perimeter. It's all set up virtually, so it's actually really neat. And if you have a dog that likes to wander or anything like that, I highly recommend. It's called Tractive, and it's great.
Thank you.
It's a girlie. Hello.
Hiya. Hi.
Hello. Hello.
Hiya.
You excited to see Mummy?
Yeah.
Hello, darling.
What? Where is it? Where have you been?
Where have you been?
Scarlet. Scarlet, where you been?
Sometimes someone's idea is just better than yours. I was struggling to figure out how to proportion my fox sculpture to mount to the wall, and my brother-in-law suggested that I make only half of the sculpture and affix it to a mirror, giving the illusion that it's floating. That was a much better idea. I had to repose it from scratch for perfect symmetry, and then I did a test 3D print and a UV cure. I tried it out at small scale, knowing that the glass was too thick on a regular mirror to make the fox look whole. I read online that you can make a first surface mirror by removing the paint from the back of any regular mirror with paint thinner and citrus oil. This seemed almost too good to be true, but I tried it anyway. I scratched it up pretty badly in the process, but it was a success. Now you can see that when I put half the fox on it, there is no gap, and the illusion works. Sometimes the best thing for your idea isn't your idea, it's someone else's. Thanks, Jonathan.
Here's a little video breaking down the cost that I spend on Todd monthly. So Todd's highest expense every month is in his diet, so he's fed a portion of raw food. On raw food alone, I spend $50 to $70 every month, and then he also gets fed frozen animals, and those cost $50 or $25 every month just because I like to get him a variation. And for treats, I typically spend $30 to $40 every month because he gets dehydrated treats. Todd also has the option of eating dry food throughout the day, so I spend about $20 on dry food every month. Next thing on my list is more of an optional expense, but I spend $15 on a cleaner every month for his cage because foxes do have a high scent, which is in their urine, but the cleaner that I use tends to get rid of it. I also added in $10 to $20 every month on toys, even though that's not an exact price because sometimes I do spend more or sometimes I don't, just depends on how long the toys last. My last major expense that I consider is his tracker, which you can see on him here, but I spend about $8 every month to keep it active, even though I pay the yearly fee, which is over $100, but broken up monthly, it's $8.